Teacher, the change of pitch of sound due to the relative motion between source and detector is a Doppler effect. I can understand the effect, but the calculation is always confusing. Is there any easier method?
Of course there is. Let's solve this by using the graphical method. Let's draw the position time graph for the motion for which the detector is at rest and the source is moving. The detector who is at rest is away from the origin O by X. The source is moving toward the detector from the origin O with a constant velocity. The source is emitting a sound with a regular interval. The period of emission is TS. The emitted sounds generated at each moment are transferring with sound velocity and then reach the detector. The detector hears the reached sound. The detected interval of reached sound is the detected period, TD. TD is shorter than TS and the detected frequency is getting larger. Higher pitch is heard. Let's calculate the effect. Let's call the velocity of sound V sound, the velocity of source Vs. From the graph, we find the following relationship between TS and TD. The key point is that the perpendicular width between the adjacent trajectories of sound can be figured out from the TS or TD. Inverse of this formula gives the relationship between the frequencies of emitted sound and the detected sound.
Oh, I see. But what if the detector is moving?
You can apply the same method. Let's draw the position time graph for the motion for which the detector is moving and the source is at rest. The source is at rest at the origin. The detector is approaching toward the source with a constant velocity. The source is emitting a sound with a regular interval. The period of emission is TS. The emitted sounds generated at each moment are transferring with sound velocity and then reach the detector. The detected sound period is TD. TD is shorter than TS and the detected frequency is getting larger, so higher pitch is heard. As a previous case, you can find the formula between TS and TD. Inverse of this formula gives the relationship between the frequencies of emitted sound and the detected sound.
That's great! So, what happens if both are moving?
Same method! Let's draw the position time graph for the motion for which the detector and the source both are moving. The source is moving toward the detector with a constant velocity from the origin O. The detector is also moving toward the source. The source is emitting a sound with a regular interval. The period of emission is TS. The emitted sounds generated at each moment are transferring with sound velocity and then reach the detector. The detected period TD is shorter than the period of source, and the detected frequency is getting larger. The sound is heard higher pitch. As a previous case, you can find the formula between TS and TD. Inverse of this formula gives the relationship between the frequencies of emitted sound and the detected sound. This is the general formula for the Doppler effect.
Wow, that's cool! Thanks, teacher!